Invokana can cause total renal failure. The FDA knows that, and they're ignoring it. See the story at drugsafetynews.com.
So everybody who's been paying attention to the news understands that right now in Burns, Oregon, we have a group of right-wing domestic terrorists that have taken over a federal wildlife building. Now, the media, for one, has been way too slow to cover this, but more importantly, they're refusing, for the most part, to call these people terrorists. And that is exactly what we are dealing with right now. They're not militiamen. They're certainly not protesters, as some media outlets have tried to say. These people are right-wing terrorists. I mean, things right now, it's just kind of helter-skelter with what's going on. And the federal government, as of right now, is trying to figure out the best way to move forward. Certainly, they can't do what they did in the case of the Bundy Ranch standoff, which was to do absolutely nothing as right-wing terrorists are pointing guns at federal agents. They also can't have another situation like Waco where they go in and kill everyone. So it is a very delicate situation for the U.S. government. But one thing is clear. If these people hold up with those assault rifles in that federal building, had a skin tone that wasn't white, they would be so riddled with bullet holes right now that you wouldn't even be able to identify their bodies. You want to know what white privilege is? It's being able to walk into a federal building with an assault rifle, take it over, bring all your friends, post videos on YouTube telling people to bring their guns and come join you, and not getting shot by a police officer. That is white privilege, ladies and gentlemen. Fox News created this little terrorist cell in America. Roger Ailes is directly responsible for what's happening in Oregon, just like they were directly responsible for what happened down at the Bundy Ranch. Fox News and right-wing talkers in general have been promoting these ideas for years now. This anti-government, anti-everything, anti-minority, anti-immigrant, just fear and rage has grown among these right-wing terrorists, and this is the end result. This is going to continue as long as these idiots keep tuning into Fox News, and as long as Fox News continues to be able to spout these horrible, completely untrue things about the U.S. government to their viewers. Action has to be taken, and not just against the people in Oregon. Those responsible, Roger Ailes, Fox News, Glenn Beck, Alex Jones, they have to be held accountable before people start dying. Because those people in Oregon, those right-wing terrorists, have made it clear they don't care if they die. And they don't care how many people they have to kill in order to prove their point, whatever in the hell that may be.